The next video in our geometry construction series is constructing a perpendicular bisector of a segment. Now, before we construct our perpendicular bisector of our segment, we need to go over what it means to be a perpendicular bisector. A perpendicular bisector is a segment that is perpendicular to the given segment, which means it intersects at a 90-degree angle. And it is a bisector. And what bisect means is to cut in half. So we are going to create segments that are perpendicular to our given segments, and they are going to cut them in half. So to begin, what we are going to do, we are going to be given a segment. So if we are given a segment, the only place that we can put our compass is on an endpoint. So if we are given a segment, the only good place to put our compass is on an endpoint. Our goal is to construct a perpendicular bisector. Bisect means we are going to cut it in half. Whenever we do any construction that involves cutting something in half, we need to extend our compass over halfway to the other side. Always try and visualize what you're doing, and that is going to help you figure out where to go next. Once you extend it over halfway, lock your compass and draw an arc above your segment and below the segment. Another big key that when you're doing constructions is if you have two things that go together, like our two endpoints here, if you do something on one endpoint, you're going to also do it on the other endpoint. So we are going to repeat step two on the other, or step one on the other endpoint, and we have to make sure that we keep the compass locked. We want to create a circle with the same radius from the other endpoint. Okay, so after we do that, we'll have a total of four arcs. They will intersect in two places. And then what we are going to do is we made the arcs. We are going to use them by connecting the intersections of the two arcs above the line and below the line with a line. And the segment that we create will represent the perpendicular bisector of our segment. So we have our segment. We need to go ahead and we are going to place our compass on one endpoint. Then we're going to extend our compass over halfway. So that looks to be about over halfway. I'm going to change our color so we can draw an arc above the line and we can draw our arc below the line. We need to make sure our arc comes up enough to where we think our perpendicular bisector will be. So that way our circles are going to intersect. Then we're going to move our compass to the other side and repeat the same thing. So we have our intersection. We intersect here, we intersect there, and so what we do then, our arcs intersect, so we are going to use them, and we are going to connect them and draw our line, and what this line is going to represent, this represents the perpendicular bisector of our segment. It is perpendicular to the segment and it cuts it in half. Okay. The reason why this construction works, the two circles that we created, the endpoints ended up being our centers and they had the same radius. So we have this radius here. This radius is congruent to this radius on this side. And if you remember back from when we did perpendicular bisectors, we had a biconditional statement that said if a point, which this blue intersection is a point, if it is equidistant from the endpoints of a segment, then it lies on the perpendicular bisector of the segment. And that is the justification for this construction. So you just completed a perpendicular bisector of a segment.